evening, Panther fans. Welcome to this Region 2A matchup between the Great Plains Lutheran Panthers and the Clark Willow Lake Cyclones. Panthers win the tip, but Emerson Larson gets the steal and the lay-in right out of the gate here for a 2-0 lead for the Clark Willow Lake Cyclones. Hayden Carley brings it back down the court for the Panthers, gets it over to Austin Rubendahl. Rubendahl back to Carley, down to Alex Heil. Heil tries to get it over to Charlemagne. A little too much on that one, and Carley comes away with it, gets it to Rubendahl. Rubendahl drives down the lane, puts it up, no good. Rubendahl fighting for the rebound, and Emerson Larson comes away with it. Larson, guarded by Charlemagne, gets it over to Begeman. Bo Begeman, guarded by Alex Heil. Kick it back around to Griffin Musser, and then back to Begeman. And Larson shoots a three from the corner, no good. And Zemlicka came away with the rebound. Clark Willow Lake still can't get it to go, and Brody Charlemagne gets the rebound. Alex Heil bringing it up for the Panthers. Hands it off to Carley. Carley back to Heil in the corner. Heil drives to his left, nothing there. Gets it inside to Miles York. York working the post, puts it up, foul. Miles York was fouled by number 23, Aaron Zemlicka. So York will go to the line to shoot two free throws. York gets the first one to go. He'll try to tie it up here with the second free throw early on in this matchup. Great Plains Lutheran, the number 4 seed. Clark Willow Lake, the number 5 seed. And he'll get the second one to go to tie it up at 2 apiece. This one should be close all the way throughout, folks. Earlier in the season, January 22nd, these two teams faced off against each other, I believe in Willow Lake. Clark came away with a 42-40 victory on a last-second shot to win the game. So we're in for a good one here tonight, folks, in this Region 2A matchup. Larson, guarded by two Panthers, gets it over to Musser. Shot clock down at 6 seconds. Begeman drives, hangs, fires, scores. Just as a shot clock was about to expire, Begeman gets that one to go for the Cyclones. Now Heil down to York. York gets it up top to Carley. Carley back to Rubendahl down in the corner. Rubendahl working on Helkin. Back to Heil. Heil drives the lane. The little up and under off the glass, no good. Larson gets it up to Zemlicka. Zemlicka gets it to Helkin. Back to Begeman. And now Begeman's got it up top. The defense chant from the Panther faithful here at the Panther Palace, as they like to call it. Shot clock to 6. Helkin drives with the left hand, no good. But Begeman's there with the rebound, and he gets it to go off the glass just as the shot clock expired. Clark Willow Lake using every last second of the shot clock, the last two possessions. Heil on the other end gets it to Charlemagne, to Carley, down low to York. York working down low, and he gets the little turn and the little kiss off the glass for 2. Musser brings it up for the Cyclones this time around. As the Panther fans cheer on the home team. Begeman's shot is off the mark, but the Cyclones get another offensive rebound. Cyclones have been getting quite a few second chance points here tonight. And there's another offensive board for the Cyclones, and then it's tapped around, and Helkin comes away with it. He gets it over to Larson, who gets it to Begeman. Begeman drives again, and he's rejected by York. The freshman was rejected by the senior, Miles York. Now Heil will drive on the other end. Miles York will put it up. No good, no foul, no harm. And the Cyclones come away with the ball. Larson to his left. Over to Musser. Back to Larson. Larson drives. Double teamed. Trapped. Down low. He gets it over to Musser. Guarded by Charlin. Back up top to Begeman. Again, the shot clock winding down to 6 seconds. And York comes away with the steal. Panthers down by two. Here with just under 3 minutes to go in this first quarter. And then York can't handle it on the other end. And the Cyclones come away with it. Then Heil pokes it away. And the Panthers come away with it. Working it up to Heil. Free layup down the middle of the lane, and he ties it up. 6-6. And Clark Willow Lakes wants a timeout to talk about it. We'll be back. Welcome back to the hundreds watching online on live on our GPL YouTube channel. We're here at Great Plains Lutheran High School and inside the Panther Palace in Watertown, South Dakota on this blustery February night for this Region 2A matchup. Clark Willow Lake's shot is off. Helkin comes away with the rebound and he can't get the put back. Out of bounds, Panther basketball. Great Plains Lutheran Panthers and Clark Willow Lake Cyclones squaring off for the second time this season. Winner will take on the winner of the Hamlin and Florence Henry game happening right now just to our south. Heil, a little fadeaway, no good. And Larson comes away with it. He gets it up to Zemlicka. Zemlicka swinging it around. Larson. Now it's poked away by Alex Heil, and it's going to be Cyclone basketball. Number 33, Sullivan Felberg, is checked in for Clark Willow Lake after the timeout, as well as Jacob Steen is in the ball game as well. Felberg gets it over to Helkin, over to Steen. Steen, cross court to Larson. 8 seconds left on the shot clock. That shot by Helkin is good. 73 seconds left to go here in this first period. Carley working on the other end. Gets it down low to Martin Krenz, who checked in for the Panthers following the timeout. Loses control. Heil gets it back to Krenz, over to Carley. Carley looks to drive, nothing there. Tries to work it inside, and it's stolen away by Zemlicka. Zemlicka, cross court to Larson. Down to Steen in the corner. 42 seconds left in the quarter. Felberg, cross court to Helkin for three, no good. And it's rebounded by Heil, who gets it down the court to Carley. Carley is going to be fouled by number 32, Jack Helkin, who gets called for the blocking foul down on the other end. So just under 30 seconds to go here in the first period. And Hayden Carley is going to shoot free throws. First one off the front of the rim. Bo Begeman will check back into the game. Steen will take a seat. Carley's second shot rims out. Helkin comes away with the rebound. 25 seconds left, shot clock turned off. Helkin, guarded by Charlemagne, gets it over to Begeman, guarded by Heil. Begeman hands it off to Felberg. Felberg. Heil tried to poke it away, and he's going to get called for a reach-in foul. So 12 seconds to go. And Hayden Carley will take a seat as Austin Rubendahl checks in for the Panthers. Felberg inbounds to Begeman. 8 seconds left. Felberg working on Heil. Tries a little Euro step up, no good. And Rubendahl comes away with it. 2 seconds left. He throws it down court, no good. Cyclones take an 8-6 lead into the second quarter. We'll be back. And we're back here with the second quarter. Begeman to Felberg. Felberg throws it up. I don't know if that was a pass or a shot, but either way, it was off the rim, and the Panthers come away with the rebound. Looked like it was going to be a pass, kind of an alley-oop type lob inside, but it rimmed off the backboard. The Panthers came away with it. Rubendahl goes up, and he's going to get fouled. Rubendahl checked in at the end of that first quarter, got in the last 15 seconds or so of the first quarter. He did get the start tonight. Sinks the first, got the start, and then Coach Mike Haugley gave him a breather there at the end of the first. Rubendahl ties it up by hitting the second free throw. Begeman is going to bring it down the court for the Cyclones. Gets it to Felberg. Felberg back to Begeman. Begeman down low. Kicks it back out to Felberg. Over to Felberg for three. Good. So the Cyclones take a three-point lead with that three-point basket. Charlemagne drives, kicks it out to Heil. Heil for three, no good. Follows his shot, but Larson comes away with it for the Cyclones. Emerson Larson, the sophomore captain, gets it out to Felberg for three. That one is off. It was contested by number 15, Martin Krenz, and it bounced off the back of the hoop. Hit the backboard, out of bounds for the turnover. Heil down to York. York to Rubendahl. Rubendahl, the little head fake, working on Jack Helkin. Gets it to Martin Krenz. Martin Krenz drives. And he tries to pass it down low to Miles York. But number 23, Aaron Zemlicka, was there and swatted the ball away. Zemlicka was standing out of bounds when he did that. And Panthers retain possession. Inbounds pass to Rubendahl, to Charlemagne, to Heil. To Rubendahl for the long three. No good off the rim. Charlemagne out-hustles everybody and gets the rebound. Gets it to Heil for three. No good. Rubendahl, the rebound. Gets it to York at the top of the key. His shot is off the back of the iron as well. Nothing falling here for the Panthers early on in the second. Steen checks back into the ballgame for the Cyclones, and then for the Panthers, it's going to be Hayden Carley coming in for Rubendahl and Landon Zerwan checking in for Miles York. Griffin Musser gets it over to Steen. Steen called for the travel. So a turnover by the Cyclones. And Hayden Carley will get across midcourt for the Panthers. Zerwan, the pass, trying to get the pass down to Heil on the backdoor cut. And it was tapped away by the Cyclones. Heil, the inbounds pass, and that is poked away by Steen. He poked it away, and then it bounced off Zerwan's foot, out of bounds, Cyclone basketball. Cyclones, the 11-8 lead here in the first quarter. 5.5 minutes left in the first half. Second quarter, I should say. I'm sorry. Scoreboard is incorrect. It is the second quarter. The shot by Helkin is good to extend the lead for the Cyclones. Carley hands it off to Charlemagne. Gets it to Heil. Kicks it out to Carley. Tries to get it inside to Landon Zerwan, and it's stolen away by Larson. Larson, the up and under, good. 15-8, 7-point lead now. And Coach Mike Haukley wants a timeout. We'll be back. And we're back in action. Hayden Carley gets it over to Martin Krenz. Krenz, the little floater, gets it to go. Cuts the lead to five, I should say, 15-10, Clark Willow Lake. Looked like a little inside pass, but it was off the rim. And it was out of bounds, Panther basketball. Heil inbounds it to Rubendahl, who just taps it back to Heil. Heil brings it down the court, gets it to Charlemagne. Charlemagne inside to Rubendahl. Rubendahl, a little turnaround, no good. Rebound by Musser. Larson will bring it up the court. Gets it over to Felberg. And then Begeman with the shot off the rim, no good. Rubendahl with the rebound. Heil to Krenz. Krenz at the top of the key. Kicks it out to Heil. Heil drives, nothing there. Gets it to Rubendahl in the corner. Rubendahl drives and is fouled by Begeman. Rubendahl went up and was fouled on the shot. So he'll shoot two again. Rubendahl gets the first one to go. That's Bo Begeman's first foul of the game. Cyclone's second of the quarter. We are in the second quarter. And Rubendahl hits the second. Cut the lead to three. Inbounds pass to Bo Begeman, who will bring it across the timeline for the Cyclones. Guarded by Alex Heil. Gets it to Musser. Out to Felberg for three from the corner. And Heil come away with the rebound. Heil hands it off to Krenz. Somehow Bo Begeman, I should say Larson, steals it away. And Larson goes up for either the layup or looked like he might have tried to dunk it there. Krenz comes from behind and gets the foul. So Larson will go to the line and shoot two. Makes the first. Somehow there was a handoff. Panthers were trying to hand it off. Somehow Larson got his hand in there and poked it away. And Larson misses the second. So the lead stays at 4 points for the Cyclones. 16-12, Clark Willow Lake has the lead. 3 minutes left here in the first half. Heil down to Rubendahl. Rubendahl to York. York back to Rubendahl. Up top to Krenz. Krenz drives, kicks it back out to Carly. Carly to Krenz. Krenz drives the lane, gets the layup, no good. A little too strong on the layup. And Emerson Larson brings it back down the court for the Cyclones. He gets it down low, they kick it out to Felberg, to Bo Begeman for the long three-pointer. Off the back of the iron, no good. Heil comes away with the rebound. Heil pushes it up court. Gets it to Carly. To Heil for three, no good. Larson tries to drive. No, nothing there. Gets it up top to Helkin, over to Begeman. Begeman down to Musser. And there's going to be a kicked ball called on the Panthers. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. 2 minutes to go in the first half. As I said, scoreboard is wrong. It should say second period. So if you're watching at home, that three-point attempt is no good, air ball. Heil tries for the layup. They're going to say he was fouled by Aaron Zemlicka, and head coach Jerome Nesham respectfully disagrees with the officials. Nesham pleading his case as Heil hits the first free throw. Second one rims out, but Miles York is there for the rebound and the putback. And scoreboard once again wrong. It should be 16-15. Accidentally gave the Clark Willow Lake the points. Should be, yes, Panthers. So 16-15, 1-point ball game here with a minute 36 to go in the first half. Begeman gets it to Larson. Larson guarded closely by Charlemagne, picks up his dribble, and then he tries to get it over to Musser. Helkin, I should say. Excuse me. 4 seconds left on the shot clock, and there's going to be a shot clock violation. Panthers hold out on defense, and they're going to get the ball back with a minute 14 to go here in the first half, down by 1 point. There was an inadvertent horn. York to Charlemagne. Charlemagne over to Heil for three, drains it, and the crowd goes crazy here at the Panther Palace to put the Panthers up by 2 points with 53 seconds to go. Begeman drives and drains it to tie it up at 18. 44 seconds left. Carley. Gets it down to Heil. Heil guarded closely by Larson, and there's going to be a foul on Larson. They're going to say his hands were all over him. It's going to be the fourth team foul here of this quarter, and it's going to be Larson's first of the game. 18-18, 30 seconds left to go here in the first half. Inbounds pass to Charlemagne. Charlemagne down low to Rubendahl. Rubendahl turns around. The little floater with the left hand is good. 20-18. Panthers take the 2-point lead. Griffin Musser brings it up. Gets it to Felberg. Felberg back to Musser. Musser back to Felberg. Inside to Helkin. Helkin shot. No good. Fight for the rebound. Out of bounds. And they're going to say it was off Austin Rubendahl. And it's going to be Cyclone basketball. The inbounds pass to Helkin. Down low to Felberg, who tries to get a shot off with 2 seconds left. I think they're going to call a foul on the Panthers. And Felberg's going to go to the line to shoot two. Foul is going to be on number three, Brody Charlemagne. Felberg's going to shoot two, trying to tie it up here at the end of the first half. First shot, no good. Second shot coming with 0.9 seconds left here in the half. Felberg's second shot is good. And we're going to go into halftime with GPL with a 20-19 lead over the Clark Willow Lake Cyclones at halftime in this Region 2A game. We'll be back. Thank you. Welcome back to the second half of this Region 2A matchup between the Clark Willow Lake Cyclones and the home team, the Great Plains Lutheran Panthers. Panthers bring a one-point lead here in the second half, 20-19 in a closely fought first half. As I said, this is going to be a good one here tonight, folks. The number 4 seed GPL and the number 5 seed Clark Willow Lake. They both squared off back in January. Clark Willow Lake coming away with that one by 2 points on a last-second shot at the end of the game. So we'll see how this one ends in the next half hour here on the campus of Great Plains Lutheran High School in Watertown, South Dakota. Charlemagne to Heil with 3 seconds on the shot clock. Heil gets it off, but it didn't hit the rim, so it's going to be a shot clock violation. And Clark Willow Lake's going to get the ball. Not the way Coach Mike Housley would want to start the second half here for GPL. Fans getting loud here, GPL. Larson gets it inside to Musser. And it's poked away, but Begeman comes away with it. And then another loose ball. And Helkin comes away with it, guarded by Charlemagne. Helkin in the corner. Gets it up top to Larson. Larson to Begeman. Begeman over to Musser. Back to Begeman. Back to Musser. Inside to Begeman. His shot falls. So Clark Willow Lake takes a 1 point lead, 21-20. Heil hands it off to Charlemagne. Charlemagne over to Carley. Carley inside to York. York working the post back to Carley for three. No good. Larson cross midcourt. Gets it over to Begeman. Begeman to Musser. Musser back to Larson. Larson for the long three. No good. Carley gets the rebound. Carley gets it over to Rubendahl. Inside to Heil. Heil off the glass, no good. So kind of a nice little give and go play there, but Heil can't get it to fall. Panthers have had a tough time getting shots to fall most of the night. Inside to Larson, he gets that one to go in the middle of the lane. And we're going to have a timeout, Panthers. They're going to want to talk about it. We'll be back. Heil inbounds to Carley out of the timeout. Carley guarded by Begeman over to Heil. Inside to York and shot no good. Had a good play drawn up there, just couldn't get it to go down low. Now Begeman gets it down to Helkin. And Rubendahl is going to be called for the foul. Looked like it was all ball from behind, but the refs, the officials, said otherwise. Jack Helkin will shoot 2 free throws. Gets the first one to go. Extends the lead to 4 points for the Cyclones. Second one is good as well. 25-20, 5 minutes to go here in the third quarter, and GPL going to try to cut into this deficit. Rubendahl hands it off to Charlemagne, who drives, kicks it out to Heil. Heil to Carly. Back to Charlemagne. Drives the lane, and there's going to be a foul on the floor. Foul is going to be on number 23, Aaron Zemlicka, his third of the game. So he's got three fouls and some foul trouble. Inbounds pass to Rubendahl, and Rubendahl gets a little turnaround floater. Cut the lead to three. The defense chant, loud and clear from the Panther faithful. The shot by Felberg, good for three. Clark Willow Lake with a 6-point advantage. Inside to York. York took a power dribble there. Nothing going down low. Carly hands it off to Charlemagne, dishes to Rubendahl. Rubendahl up and off the glass and good. Just under 4 minutes to go here in this third quarter. Four-point ball game. Begeman, shot no good. And out of bounds, and they're going to say it was last touched by the Panthers. Landon Zerwan and Martin Krenz check in for the Panthers. And Coach Nesham's going to send in substitution as well. Zemlicka is going to check into the ball game. Took a seat after getting his third foul of the game earlier here in the third quarter. Begeman to Larson. Back to Begeman. Begeman cross court to Felberg for three. No good. Krenz comes away with the rebound. Krenz gets it over to Heil. Heil looking up court to Carly in the corner for three. No good. And the Panthers' shooting woes continue. Begeman over to Larson. Guarded by three Panther defenders. And then Begeman tries to drive the lane and get the floater, but nothing going. And the Panthers come away with the rebound. Krenz drives, stops, pops, good. Cuts the lead to two with just over 2 minutes to go here in the third quarter. 28-26, Clark Willow Lake has the lead, and they've got the ball. Bo Begeman working on Alex Heil, kicks it out to Felberg for three, good. Felberg continues to hit from long distance in the third quarter. He's had several three-pointers tonight. I don't have the stats in front of me right now, but he's hit a couple long ones. Heil, his shot is good. And Coach Mike Haugley is going to call a timeout. We'll be back. Welcome back inside the Panther Palace to the hundreds watching online on the GPL YouTube channel. We've got a good one here for you tonight. 31-28, Clark Willow Lake has the lead with a minute and a half to go here in the third quarter. Musser gets it up top to Larson, who gets it over to Steen. Steen to Felberg. Felberg directing traffic. Minute 22 to go, 14 seconds on the shot clock. Musser. Zemlicka gets it to Musser. Felberg shoots the three in and out, no good. Krenz the rebound. He gets it to Zerwan. Zerwan looked back at Krenz and said, I don't want to take this ball back up court. So he got it back to the ball handlers and it's poked away by the Cyclones. Exactly 60 seconds to go here in the third. Miles York will check in for Landon Zerwan in this three-point ball game. Heil, inbounds pass to Carley. Carley guarded by Felber, gets it to Heil, shoots for three, good. Ties it up, 31-31. Alex Heil hits from long range. And the defense chant ensues. Bo Begeman over to Jack Helkin. Back to Begeman, over to Larson. Back to Felberg for three, no good. That one's off the rim, out of bounds, Panther basketball. Thirty seconds to go in the third quarter, all tied up at 31 apiece. And Hayden Carley brings the ball up for the Panthers as coach Mike Haugley shouts out the play call from the sidelines. Shot clock is off. Clark Willow Lake fans with the defense cheer now. Gets it to Charlemagne, 9 seconds to go. Over to Krenz, down low to Miles York, who's gonna be fouled. Foul's gonna be on, see who they credit that one to. Foul's gonna be on number 23, Aaron Zemlicka. That's his second of the game. 4 seconds to go. Get into Charlemagne for three. No good. York is there with the rebound, but it's swatted away out of bounds. There's not much they can do here, I think, on the inbounds pass with 0.3 seconds left. But all they can do is get a little tip pass to try to get it to go. And he gets it to go. Are they going to give him the bucket? Yes, they do. So Hayden Carley gets a last-second bucket for the two-point lead going into the third quarter. The officials aren't talking about it. We will see if they continue, if they'll allow that bucket to go. They're going to say no basket. No basket. Headed to the fourth. We'll be back. All right, so we head into the fourth quarter with a 31-31 ball game. That basket by Hayden Carley, initially they called it good, but then waved it off because there's no physical way. And we're going to have a traveling call on the Cyclones. Turnover here. And they're saying there's a problem with the clock because it's at 7:59. Clock should have, there's no way that 1 second was only 1 second expired from the clock while Clark Willow Lake had possession. Anyway, getting back to the end of the third quarter there, where there's 0.3 seconds left on the clock. Inbounds to Carley, he caught it and got the shot off. So there was a little human error involved there with the clock operator and the shot getting off. There should be no physical way that you can catch the ball and shoot it with 0.3 seconds left. And that's what the officials said. So that was no basket or tie ball game, 31-31. They now adjusted the clock down to 7:45 with the opening possession for Clark Willow Lake. And we're back in action. Miles York in the middle of the lane, rims out. Rebound by Bo Begeman. Begeman hands it off to Zemlicka. Zemlicka to Larson. Larson back to Begeman. Begeman guarded closely by Charlemagne. Over to Felberg. Back to Begeman. Back to Larson. Cross court to Felberg for the open three-pointer. Good. Felberg is feeling it from long distance tonight. Gives the Clark Willow Lake Cyclones a three-point lead. Heil gets it to Krenz, over to Charlemagne. Charlemagne drives, tries to dish it to Krenz, but it is stolen away by Jack Helkin. Felberg up top to Begeman. Begeman to Helkin. And there's going to be a travel called on the Cyclones. Turnover, Panther basketball. So that's the second travel called here early in the fourth quarter on the Cyclones. Panthers down by three. Get a down low to York, who puts it up. A little too strong off the rim. Cyclones come away with it. Bo Begeman looking to the sidelines to see what he's supposed to run. Gets it to Felberg. Felberg, the shot. Gets it to drop. Extends the lead to 5 points for the Cyclones. Heil over to Rubendahl for three. Good. Austin Rubendahl responds with a three-pointer to cut the lead back to two. Bo Begeman over to Felberg. Felberg inside to Helkin. Back outside to Musser. They try the interior pass, and it's swatted away by the Panthers, and it's going to remain down here on this end with the Cyclones. Landon Zerwan checks in for the Panthers. Miles York's going to take a breather. 5.5 minutes left here in the game. 2-point ball game. Felberg for three. No good. One of the few that he's missed here tonight. Carley comes away with the rebound. He gets it up to Rubendahl. Thought about the three-pointer for the minute. He gets it over to Charlemagne. Charlemagne down to Rubendahl. Rubendahl looking inside. Drives the baseline. Nothing there. Gets it to Heil. Heil in the middle of the lane. No good. And Felberg gets the ball. And I think he was out of bounds. They're either going to say... Oh, they're going to call a foul on Zerwan. They're going to say Zerwan pushed Felberg out of bounds. And they're going to credit that foul to the Panthers. So Bo Begeman bringing it back up the court now for the Cyclones. Gets it down to Larson. Begeman over to Felberg, guarded by two Panthers. The pass, a little long, no good. The Cyclone faithful wanted a foul. It looked like Rubendahl might have gotten away with a push in the back on that one. Charlemagne stops, gets it over to Rubendahl, to Carley at the top of the key, over to Heil. Heil looking down low, gets it to Rubendahl. Rubendahl, directing traffic from the post, gets it to Zerwan, back around to Charlemagne. 10 seconds on the shot clock, Rubendahl. Over to Charlemagne, 6 seconds, Charlemagne tries to get the pass over to Heil and it's stolen away by Larson. Larson's gonna get the left-handed layup to go and a 4-point lead with 4 minutes left here in this ball game. Carley, the shot, no good. Zerwan gathers the rebound, gets it to Heil. Heil's gonna get fouled by multiple Cyclones surrounding him and he's gonna get fouled and go to the line to shoot two. They're gonna credit that foul to number 3, Emerson Larson. There were about 3 Cyclones around Heil as he went up for that shot. And Heil misses the first free throw. Heil's second free throw also off the rim. Gathered by Zerwan. His shot is too strong, no good. And the Cyclones keep the ball, get the ball back. Under 4 minutes to go. Begeman over to Larson. Back to Begeman over to Felberg. Guarded closely by Krenz and Heil. Now Begeman's gonna hit a 3-pointer. Cyclones have been dialed in from long distance all night long. Krenz. The ball up top to Rubendahl. Rubendahl to Heil for 3. No good. Rebound by Begeman. Guarded by Heil and Charlemagne. Gets it to Felberg for 3. Good. And we're going to have a timeout and a 10-point lead for Clark Willow Lake. We'll be back. We're back with just under 3 minutes to go here in the ball game. Clark Willow Lake with a 10-point lead, 44-34. Krenz gets it into Rubendahl. Rubendahl turns around from 15 feet, no good. Rebounded by Krenz. Krenz tries to get a reverse layup to go, nothing there. And Charlemagne slips through his hands, dives on the floor, gets it to Heil. Heil up to Krenz. Krenz is gonna drive, and he's gonna get fouled, and he's gonna go shoot 2 free throws. Wild start here out of the timeout. The Panthers turning up the aggression. And Krenz's first free throw is gonna roll off the rim. Panthers just cannot get anything to fall here tonight. He'll get the second one to go. Cut the lead to 9. Start to chip away with 2.5 minutes left. Begeman hands it off to Larson. Larson back to Begeman. Felberg was working inside, looking for the basketball. Gets it around to Jack Helkin. Inside, poked away by Heil, but they get it back, and Begeman from the corner will drain a three-pointer. Heil tries to get it over to York, and a little miscommunication, and it goes out of bounds. Turnover. Cyclone basketball. ...47-35, Cyclones with a 12-point lead, now with 1:50 to go in this ball game. Larson over to Begeman. Begeman works it around the arc, back to Larson. Larson to Helkin. Helkin down low to Begeman. Begeman drives the baseline, puts it up, no good, and Clark will call a timeout, and we'll be back in a minute. Minute 28 to go. Clark Willow Lake has a 47-35 lead over the Great Plains Lutheran Panthers, and Hayden Carley is going to foul Bo Begeman. So he's going to foul him. Intentional foul. 2 fouls apiece for each team here in the fourth quarter. And Miles York is going to take a seat, and Thad Kratz will check into the ballgame. Inbounds pass stolen away by Charlemagne. Charlemagne drives, turns, spins, fires, no good. Out to Kratz for 3, no good. Charlemagne there with the rebound. He gets it out to Carley for 3, no good. And it's going to be jump ball. Jump ball, possession, GPL Panthers. So York and Rubendahl will check back into the ball game, and Krenz and Kratz will take a seat. Not quite sure what the discussion is here. Looks like there might be something on the court trying to get it wiped up. It looks like Emerson Larson's over there on the Clark Willow Lake bench getting a bandage on his knee. So might have had a little bit of blood on the court. And I would think they would make Clark Willow Lake either call a timeout or substitute. You can't just put a bandage on somebody's knee. Okay, well, they're going to tape up his knee. give him that time, I guess, and tape up his knee, and play resumes. Heil looking for the inbounds, gets it to Carley for three off the backboard, and Felberg hits the floor. He's going to be fouled by a Panther. I'm going to say it was on 24, I believe. Miles York, yes, that's his first. Panthers are going to put on the full court press here with 62 seconds left. Krenz is going to check in for York. York's going to take a seat. So Clark Willow Lake gets the inbound pass and immediately fouled by Rubendahl. And we got another timeout. We'll be back. So coming out of the foul, Clark Willow Lake will get the inbounds pass to Bo Begeman. Emerson Larson, excuse me. Get it in the 3 and 5 on these green numbers on these dark jerseys. Kind of hard to see who is who, but Larson's going to go to the free throw line now with 5 team fouls here in the fourth quarter. Again, if you haven't tuned in all season, new high school rules this year. Team fouls reset every quarter. Once you hit 5, the other team's automatically in the double bonus. So we're shooting 2 free throws every time there's a foul now on Clark Willow Lake. Or should I say, every time the Panthers foul a Clark Willow Lake player, they'll be shooting 2 free throws. Heil to Rubendahl. Drives, hangs. No good. Rubendahl gets it out to Heil. 45 seconds to go. York down low. Gets that one to fall. And the Panthers will put on the full court press, but not before Coach Mike Haugley calls a timeout. We'll be back. We're back out of the timeout. Panthers are putting on the full court press with 39 seconds here. Looks like they're going to run somewhat of a football play. And Charlemagne's going to get called for the foul. He's going to foul Sullivan Felberg, who's hit a myriad of three-pointers here tonight. Felberg is going to go to the free throw line with 38 seconds left. Kind of looked like a football play there that the Clark Willow Lake Cyclones set up. Felberg's free throw falls. They had four players line up on the baseline, and when the player taking it out of bounds said go, they all ran kind of a route, wide receiver's route. Misses a second. Rubendahl gets it up to Carley. Carley drives, his shot no good, and it's taken away by Musser. Musser's going to be fouled immediately, and he's going to go to the free throw line as the Clark Willow Lake Cyclones have a 13-point lead, 50-37, here with 28 seconds left in the ball game. Clark Willow Lake, the number 5 seed. GPL, the number 4 seed, so somewhat of a mild upset here tonight. That shot is no good by Griffin Musser. Rubendahl is going to check out of the ball game, and the senior Martin Krenz will come into the game. Both of the seniors on the court right now for the Panthers, Miles York and Martin Krenz. Heil drives, gets the layup to go. 19 seconds to go, and there's going to be a foul by Hayden Carley on, I believe, number 24, Griffin Musser will go to the line. Foul is Carley's second of the ball game. Not that it really matters anymore, 15 seconds left. And it looks like Coach Mike Haugley is going to send in a couple sophomores, going to get some playing time here with 17 seconds to go. Going to substitute. Believe the seniors will check out. Alex Heil, senior. Martin Krenz, a senior. And Miles York, a senior. All get a standing ovation from the crowd here. At GPL. Jarrett Bauer, the sophomore, tries to get the rebound and it goes off his leg. No good. And looks like Coach Jerome Nesham's going to do the same. Get a few players some playing time in a playoff game. Bunch of substitutions for Clark Willow Lake. His starting five will take the bench. 15 seconds to go. Inbounds pass to Vandersnick. That shot is off the mark. Hayden Carley comes away with it. 6 seconds to go. Jarrett Bauer, the three-pointer, no good. And going to be out of bounds on Krenz, and that's going to be the ball game, folks. Clark Willow Lake is moving on. They'll take on the winner of Hamlin and Florence Henry. And the Panther season is over with a final record of 13-8 on the year. That's a wrap on the season, folks. Thanks for watching. Hope you can join us next year. Thank you.